Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Media here. Today we're going to be talking about P0401 engine fault codes. A P0401 code is going to read exhaust gas recirculation flow insufficient detected, or something very similar to that. EGR, or exhaust gas recirculation, is an emission system that takes exhaust gases and passes them back into the engine to reburn all of the harmful particulates that are left over from the combustion process before then sending that gas out through the exhaust system. The whole purpose is to reduce nitrogen oxide and lower emissions. So it takes that dirty exhaust gas and passes it back in the engine to help clean it a little bit more. EGR is predominantly used in diesel engines. So this video is going to be most applicable to diesel engines, modern diesels and older diesel engines that have exhaust gas recirculation, but EGR was also used on some gas engines back in the 90s and even a little bit in the early 2000s as well. However, you don't see EGR on newer gas engines, and that is because the adoption of variable valve timing has really made EGR not necessary for gas engines to meet emissions requirements. The P0401 code is extremely prevalent on Fords and especially on the 6.0 power strokes, but this is a code that you can get on any diesel engine. And so we're gonna go ahead and cover the signs and symptoms that you'll get with a P0401 code, as well as talk about some of the causes and some steps to help you go ahead and diagnose what the problem is when this fault code is present. So first off, jumping into the symptoms, obviously the first thing that you're gonna get is a P0401 engine fault code. You're also gonna notice a number of other symptoms that you're getting while you're getting this engine code. And understanding what other symptoms you're getting can also help you diagnose what the exact problem might be. So you definitely wanna be on the lookout for any other thing that's happening while you're getting this engine fault code. A few of those things can be a loss of power or a lack of acceleration. You can get rough idling. Also, increased turbo lag, whistling noises likely coming from the turbocharger, or smoking coming from the tailpipe. So alongside a P401, you're likely gonna get some of these, and these are gonna help you diagnose what exactly the cause is. So make sure you pay attention to all the other things that are going on. This isn't an exhaustive list of the most common causes. There are tons of different things that can cause a P0401, but there are probably 6 or 7 things that are the most likely, and 2 or 3 that are usually the cause of the problem. So starting off with that list, the 3 things that are usually causing this problem, the most likely is gonna be the EGR pressure sensor, which is also known as the DPFE sensor. The second is gonna be a clogged EGR valve or a dirty EGR valve. And then the third is gonna be a clogged EGR cooler. So a P401 is EGR flow is insufficient. So that means that you have a restriction within the flow of the EGR system, which means that not enough exhaust gas is being able to be passed back into the engine. And so there's a restriction somewhere within the system that takes that exhaust gas and cycles it back into the engine. So what we can get here is clogging within the EGR valve. Because we're taking dirty gases and passing them back into the engine, there is a degree of diesel particulates and dirty particles that are left over. And so those can gunk up the EGR valve, which will restrict flow. Additionally, those can gunk up the EGR cooler. The EGR coolers are also known to fail from time to time. And so if you have a failed EGR cooler, that can restrict flow as well. So those are going to be the 2 most likely components that are restricting airflow. And then the DPFE sensor is a sensor that goes bad from time to time. And with that sensor going bad, you're not actually going to have a restriction of airflow. Your engine's just going to think that you have a restriction of airflow. And so that sensor going bad is probably the best case scenario, just since it's going to be one of the easiest things to fix as well as to diagnose here. But outside of the DPFE sensor, the EGR valve, and the EGR cooler, you can also get clogged EGR passages or clogged hoses. You can also have a dirty mass airflow sensor, a dirty intake manifold, or if you have a boost leak, an exhaust leak, or a vacuum leak, this can also cause a P0401 code as well. Because there's a lot of different things that can cause this, we kind of have to use a process of elimination as well as look at some of the other symptoms that we're getting to determine what the exact issue is. From a diagnosis standpoint, the first thing to do is check to see what other codes are present. If you have a P0299 or a P132B, that is usually an indication that you've got a boost leak somewhere and that the boost leak is causing the P0401. So go ahead and look for any other codes that are present, as well as keep an eye out for some of these other symptoms like turbo lag or whistling noises coming from the turbocharger. Those can also be an indication that you have a boost leak rather than a failed DPFE sensor. The second step is going to be trying to clean or replace the DPFE sensor as well as the mass airflow sensor, since that's usually easily accessible as well. But since the DPFE sensor is the most common cause of this, I'd recommend pulling that and trying to clean it or just replacing the DPFE sensor to see if that fixes it. If you pull the DPFE and the MAF sensor and you either clean them or replace them and you're still getting this error code, then the next thing is going to be to pull off the EGR valve and try manually cleaning the EGR valve to see if there's a lot of gunk or residue that is restricting airflow from there. If you don't have an issue with the EGR valve, then the next thing is going to be looking into the EGR cooler. There are ways to test the EGR cooler by doing a flow test, which will let you know if there's any restriction within the flow in the EGR cooler. I'm not going to get into how exactly to do that, but if it's not the valve, then I'd look into the cooler as well as doing some type of flow test to ensure that that's the problem. Just since replacing the EGR cooler can be expensive, I wouldn't go ahead and do that without flow testing it to confirm if there is a restriction within the cooler itself. The last option here is going to be pulling the intake manifold. The intake manifold can get dirty and gunked up from all of these dirty gases being passed back through it. Pulling the exhaust manifold and checking for any restriction in there is probably the last case option, just because it is a little bit more challenging to pull the manifold. Outside of that, the other thing that you're going to want to do is take a look at all of your hoses there, especially any vacuum lines or boost solenoid lines and things like that, just to see if you have any type of boost leak or air leak, vacuum leak within the system that could be causing this as well. If you're getting a boost leak or an exhaust leak, you're going to notice some whistling from the turbocharger. You're going to get probably some exhaust gas smells if you have an exhaust leak within the cab, a louder exhaust note. And you'll notice turbo lag and other turbocharger related issues, maybe the inability to build boost if you have a boost leak. Checking all of your lines and hoses to make sure that it's not a boost leak is a good option before jumping into some of these other more advanced things like flow testing the EGR cooler, just since it's a little bit easier to look around and look at all of your vacuum lines to see if you have any issues there. So that covers it on our symptoms, causes, and diagnosing a P0401 code. Again, your problems are most likely going to come from the DPFE sensor. If not the DPFE sensor, it's either going to be the EGR valve or the EGR cooler, but it can also be some of these other things that we mentioned on the list. One of the best things to do is start with the easy things and then move on to the harder things. So start by checking your DPFE sensor, mass airflow sensor. Check for any boost leaks or air leaks, exhaust leaks that you can see. And then from there, we can get into some more of the advanced stuff like pulling the EGR valve and cleaning it, flow testing the EGR cooler, and then checking the intake manifold to see if that's gunked up as well. Like I mentioned, this is popular on Fords and 6.0 power strokes. If this does happen to you on a Ford, a popular thing to do is to do a self-test that is usually referred to as a KOER, as well as a KOEO self-test, which either means key on engine running or key on engine off. This is going to indicate if you have a hard fault. And when you have a hard fault, that is going to be accompanied with another engine code. And whatever that other engine code is usually the cause of the hard fault. This is a good diagnostic step that can help pinpoint exactly what the issue is. We do have an article on Diesel IQ to help you perform some of these tests, but if you Google KOER Ford test or KOEO test, you should be able to find a good video or article online on how to perform those. And maybe I'll do a video on this in the future with my F350. Overall, this can be a little bit tricky to diagnose, but hopefully I've helped pinpoint what the causes are and given you some steps to help diagnose it. That's all we've got for this video. If you have any questions or need any further clarification, please shoot a message down in the comments below. If not, I hope you guys appreciated this video. Please click the like button, subscribe to our channel, and stay tuned for future videos.